Welcome, one and everyone, to this week's episode of Scotch and Smoke Rings, episode 129. That's right, we have been doing this fine program filled with cigars, tobacco pipes, scotch, and beverages of all shapes and sizes for 129 weeks. I am your neighborhood friendly Oxhorn here, set with my suspenders to maximum stun.
And I am Oxhorn's brother, Brian.
Yes.
A.K.A. Beanstalk.
A.K.A. Beanstalk. The handsomer of the two of us. Today, we have a fantastic show for you today. I am going to go over website changes. I'm going to go over presents that you guys have sent me. I'm going to show off fan art. But before any of that, we have to do what is traditional here at scotchandsmokerings.com. Something that is expected, that is healthy, and that is good for the whole world. And that is to light our cigars. Today, I am smoking this Churchill, and it has a significant gauge to it. It's much larger than your traditional Churchill cigar in terms of girth. And this is called a 1995 Chubbies Handmade.
Yeah, well, it looks quite chubby to me, so.
I'm officially going to be smoking a Chubby on camera. So, my brother, what is he smoking today?
It's Alec Bradley.
Alec Bradley?
Yeah, look at the insignia on that. It's quite exotic.
That's a pretty great band, I gotta admit. And just so you know that I'm not making it up, there you go. It says Chubbies right there. Alright, so.
He's got a big chubby.
Okay, thank you. I didn't go there for a specific reason. Alright, if I can even cut this thing. Ah, there we go. My gentlemanly brother is using a non-traditional and ungentlemanly lighter. And I am instead...
I'm using the beer lighter.
True, it does say beer on
That's
it.
That's beer.
It's a beer lighter. It's pretty great. I have opted to go for a match made from cedar to impart a lovely flavor to my cigar. So before I get into the rest of the program, I gotta tell you a story. So I was invited to what was called a smoke-easy by my friend Red, who was a very talented gentleman.
Who is he? Where'd you meet him?
I met him at work. He was sharing the office that I work at with his company that he was at the time.
Oh, so it was a different company?
Yeah, it was a different company. He wasn't a fellow employee, but he shared the same office. His name is Red. He's a short guy, full of personality, bright red curly hair, and a red beard. Very nice guy. He found out that I hosted a show called Scotch and Smoke Rings, and he says, "Oh, Oxhorn, you have got to come to the Smokeasy." And I'm like, all right. So a few nights ago, after work, I drove out into the middle of the Soto District in Seattle, because that's where the Smokeasy was going to go. And I went to the address, and I'm looking at the address on my phone, and then I look up to the door, and something looks a little off. I mean, the walls are covered in graffiti, and it's in a kind of sketchy neighborhood, train tracks nearby, and the directions said, "Look for the red door." And I'm like, all right. So I'm looking for the red door, and I found the red door, and there was this flickering light bulb above it. And I'm sitting there kind of going, what is this, a new version of The Matrix or something? But I come up to the red door, and I knock really quietly, and suddenly it creaks open, and this guy emerges in a button-down vest, wearing a bow tie and black slacks, his hair neatly parted and separated by gel. And he says, "Good evening, sir."
Really?
Really? And I'm not even making this up.
Out of this, like, worn-down industry-type building with a red door.
Exactly.
You're going to get mugged at if
right.
you're going down the wrong alley.
I thought I was in a very urban area, right? Yeah. But no. This guy opens it up in a nice, classy vest wearing shiny black shoes. So he lets me into this place, and I walk up this wooden step to go through another gate. There were, like, three gates we had to get to. I emerge into this dimly lit lounge. There was classy music, very akin to what you're listening to right now, playing. There were leather seats dotting the area. I saw a full picture of Winston Churchill smoking a cigar. Paintings right there. There was Theodore Roosevelt. There was Mark Twain on the walls. It was solid brick. It was gorgeous with wooden beams. And then at the back of this building was a huge cedar locker. So you know, remember when you were in sports and you would go into the gym and there were all these lockers in the locker room? It was like that, only they were made out of the purest, sweet-smelling cedar. And on each door was a man's name engraved in gold. So I talked to the guys who are putting on this little smokeasy, and they tell me that, yeah, this is a private club that you have to apply for membership for. So in order to be accepted into this club, you have to go through, you have to turn in two applications. You have to go through this vetting process to make sure that you really uphold the standards of this private smoking venue.
Oh, is that right?
That's right. And they told me that, you know, I can talk about it, but I can't tell anyone the name of it. I can't tell anyone the address of it.
Wow.
It's kind of like a
secret society.
It's a secret kind of place, you know? Because the laws in Seattle really, they don't really like smokers. And so in order to keep the profile low, they don't want people to talk about it, even though I am now talking about it on a live TV show. But,
Well, do you think they would accept the Beanster?
I think they would.
No.
You would have to come looking like this, with your fedora and your nice striped shirt. They would sit you down and you would say, yes, I am a fine gentleman. In my free time, I polish my shoes. That is my hobby. And then they would let you into this.
Oh, is that right?
They would let you in, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, come on. I would like to be myself on there, and that's not...
Hey, okay, just look. While I was there, and he was a nice guy, I sat down. The entire thing went on for many, many hours. I actually had to leave early. There were probably about 20, 25 people there. They had an open bar. They gave me free cigars. We had this guy who's like he was the spokesman for a cigar company and a liquor company in the area. He gave us this great presentation. They had TVs on the wall showing off really great stuff. And, you know, I sat down and chatted with a number of people. One of the guys is the guy who works in Ballard, where I work, and he had a huge nose earring sticking out of his ear, and he had, like, this weird mohawk thing, and, you know, the majority of people were dressed very classily, but there are a few people who weren't, and that wasn't terribly frowned upon. As long as you live a classy lifestyle in your other life, you will be admitted.
Well, I think you forgot that we haven't put our drinks yet.
I was busy talking.
He's going on a big rant about a story.
I was having a good time.
I haven't poured my drinks yet. So, my brother did not stock up on the beverages this week. We have no scotch. We have no rum.
I know. I feel really bad.
We have no Kraken. So, I am forced to rummage his shelf and find what I may. We found this wine, this Lambrusco. Reunite. Whatever. Soft red wine from the heart of Italy. So, I'm going to be drinking this wine tonight and... Ox, what are you going to be drinking?
I am going to be drinking gin. Now, there's a story behind this gin. This gin is many years old. I was given this as a gift by one of my old bosses. Remember those Wii Game days way back in 2008 when I worked at Wii Game? Well, wow, that's a lot of wine! Anyway, that's a lot of wine. Anyway, so back in the Wii Game days, they threw this huge party. It was my birthday party, and after the party... They had a whole bunch of leftover booze. And after I was laid off a few months later, they said, you know, we're going to give you some of this booze. And they gave me this. And I still have it. Because it's nasty. It's really, really horrible, horrible. Just horrible
stuff.
It's
been sitting on a shelf for as long as I can remember.
Yeah. It's been sitting there since 2008.
Well, when I came over and I seen it for the first time, he said he used it to clean his pipes.
I do.
So he's tonight, folks, he's going to be drinking the stuff he uses to clean his smoking utensils.
Because I'm out of all other forms of alcohol. And I'm stuck using my sanitary alcohol.
Well, you tell me how that is. I'm going to be enjoying this smooth going down one.
But before we start, I kind of want to show you a trick. So, and I'm going to need my brother's help for this. So I'm going to pour a little bit.
Let me smell it.
Pretty strong, huh? All right. How you digging that? Okay. Now here's the trick.
You know the lights?
Yeah.
All right.
Wait. Hold on. One second. Don't turn them off yet. So here's the thing. It's light outside. You can't. It's. The lights are all on, and so I set my flame. All right. Do you see anything? No. Okay. Turn off lights. And the monitors are really bright, so I guess I'm going to turn off my monitor really quick. All right. Turn off the monitor. You see that?
No one hold it.
Come on, booze. Why aren't you doing this?
Do it again.
All right. I'll do it again.
Is this going to work? This stuff maybe it only works on new alcohol.
No, I've done it with this exact same stuff before.
Have you?
Yeah.
All right.
So the what I'm trying to show you guys is that this has a near invisible blue flame that can only be seen when you turn all the lights off. There. Oh, did you see it? It was there for a moment. There we... Oh!
I seen it for a second.
It was there for a moment. Here, maybe I need to fill it up with more.
It's old.
Anyway, alright. Well, I thought I was going to do a really cool trick here for you guys and show you the flammable properties of my gin, but sadly the fates conspired against me and I was unable to do so.
The
fates.
Oh, I thought you said the feds.
No, the fates. The fates conspired against me, not the feds. The feds are on my side.
Oh, friend. Okay.
They want me to succeed in life.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. All right, now that I've stuck a bunch of burning matches in here, I'm going to drink it. And to do so, I can't drink it straight. This stuff is just so nasty that I cannot drink it straight. So what?
Oh, it's not that bad.
Is it not that bad?
No, take a sip.
All right, I'll take a sip. It's warm. Wow. Well, it's not as bad as I remember.
Yeah.
All right. It's got quite an aftertaste, though.
I mean, have you done that before, mixed it with club soda?
I haven't, no, but this is a traditional, classy way of enjoying beverages. Have you ever heard of scotch and soda?
I guess so, yeah.
Yeah, so what they would do is, I forget what they're called. So back in the days, they had this. And this is a modern version of it, but it was basically a soda machine. They would have a little squirter, and they would squirt a little soda into their scotch. And I don't have one of those, but I do have some of that. There we go. All
right.
So now we have a little bit of soda with my drink. And that's going to cut it and make it drinkable. Cheers. Whew! Quite a kick. Barking at the Moon says it's called seltzer. Yes, I do realize it's called seltzer water. But there's a specific, thing. What's it called? Crap. I know what it is, but there's a specific item that they used to have that, would help them make it. And I have it here, something, on my website, because I'm going to be getting into that in a little bit.
For all you saying hi to me, hi back, Pedro the Bear, and a couple others earlier. Hello.
You going to say anything else to them besides hello?
Like what?
I don't know, something interesting.
Good to see.
Something that asserts your charming personality.
I don't have a charming personality.
Yes, I think you do. You just don't know it.
I'm soulless. I have no personality.
Soulless?
Yes.
I wouldn't be soulless if I had no personality.
What?
Anyway. Haha. Bad pun. What was it called? Blimey, I can't find it. Anyway, I forget what it was called, but it doesn't matter. So, okay, a lot of announcements. So first of all, you are here at scotchandsmokerings.com. If you're at oxhorn.com, where I used to host my show, please come to scotchandsmokerings.com right now. We're going to stop the program for just a minute so that you can all type in scotchandsmokerings.com.
What?
We're going to be quiet for 15 seconds so that you don't miss anything. 3, 2, 1.
Excuse me.
And we're back! Don't worry, you didn't miss anything! Nothing whatsoever. There was no volcanic eruption, there was no loud obnoxious noise. You missed absolutely nothing while you were gone. Thank you all for coming to scotchandsmokerings.com. But now that you were here, you're gonna notice some changes here. At the very top of this page, you're gonna see 4 navigational links: shop, wishlist, episodes, and about. First of all, the wish list is brand new. Yes, I've had an Amazon wish list in the past, but I've decided to make it easier for you all to send me awesome gifts. And you have been sending me awesome gifts, and I'm going to get to that in just a second. So if you click on wish list, you will see a list of all of the things that I wish for, and you are free to buy them and send them to me. I will not hold it against you. In fact, I may laud you for it. Secondly, many of you have said, Oxhorn, you're a classy guy. Why have you never opened up a classy shop? Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to tell you that today, I have opened up a classy shop. That's right, if you click shop on scotchandsmokerings.com, you will be able to browse a selection of things that I have handpicked for being as classy as they are. And not only that, but I have written very humorous and classy descriptions for each item, including pictures from long-forgotten days, to make them just feel a little more Classy.
He did. He also gave me my own personal endorsement on the fedora hat that he's selling in the shop.
I didn't even solicit him for it.
He didn't.
I just knew that he would be...
He knew already that I would endorse that fedora, so he went ahead and did it already.
So right now we have about 12 different products available at scotchandsmokerings.com. We've got fedora hats. We've got pocket watches. We've got pipes. All sorts of things. Suspenders are coming. Derbies are coming. Stay tuned. Next week there should be more items for you.
Wow, they must be having a blast at the fight. There's no one's chatting. Okay, here are a couple of people.
Yeah, they finally started chatting. Right. Well, maybe we had a lag spike or something. Anyway, so there we go. There are the changes to scotchandsmokerings.com. Next, I've got to show off the awesome gifts you guys have sent me. So this week alone, you guys have sent me three different things.
Where?
And they're all amazing. First...
Do you remember who sent them to you?
They're all anonymous.
Were they?
Yeah, every single one of them were anonymous gifts, or else I would be thanking you all profusely. But the first is this pocket watch. And I'm going to hold it up there so that you can see how classy this is. Look at that. You can see the timepiece in there.
Wow.
Isn't that neat?
It is neat.
Yeah. And it's windable, so it'll never run out. Yeah. It's a winding watch.
That is really cool, actually.
Yeah. I was really stoked. So, I don't know who you were. You're obviously an Oxhorn fan, and you come to scotchandsmokerings.com, and you appreciate the show. And I can't thank you enough. I have been wanting a new stopwatch, or pocket watch, for a considerable amount of time. I had one back in the day. Any of you long-term Oxhorn fans, you will remember it. But this is my new one, and this is now going to become a permanent part of the Oxhorn Ensemble. So thank you very much, whoever you are, for giving me this fantastic pocket watch.
That is nice.
The next gift that we got is for Jody.
Let's panic about babies.
And on the cover, there is a baby shooting laser beams at the mother.
Out of her eyeballs.
Out of her eyeballs. So someone...
Not too much to ask for is babies with freaking laser beams shooting out of her eyeballs? Yeah,
that's not too much. So this is a very humorous book. My wife Jody has been reading it because, as you know, we're expecting. And it has a lot of great advice, and it's pretty... Oh... That's nice. Not gonna read that one out loud. Okay, well, won't be reading that one out loud either. So
wow.
I don't know if this is necessarily a classy book, but it's funny and Jody loves it, so thank you very much for that.
It's been on that screen for a long time.
Yeah, I know, I've got that paused.
See? Oh, I got you.
Watch what happens if I click play.
Well, nobody's been saying anything either.
Well, they have. So there we go. Well, maybe it was just paused or
Look
something.
Look at that.
Well, the last comment was, see, 717. They're all talking right there.
Right, I know, but we haven't been seeing it for, like, a good minute.
All right, well, I don't know. There it is. The chat may be coming in waves. I'm not sure.
So what was the third gift?
The third gift, which I can't show you.
Why not?
Well, the third gift was a beautiful, soft fleece blanket.
Oh.
And it's currently in the bedroom. I would have brought it in here, but then it would have smelled like cigar. And that's not necessarily a good thing. So somebody sent us an awesome fleece blanket, and it's so nice that we've got it on the bed right now, and it's fantastic. Thank you very much for the fleece blanket. And I'm going to turn this a little bit, just so we have a better picture. There we go. Now we're a little bit more centered. All right, next up, it's time to show off your fan art. And we only have one piece of fan art this week, so thank you.
Nobody's chatting again.
Well, we're obviously... It's coming in big blurbs.
I know, see?
So this must be like a live stream issue. All right, so the thing is, we're seeing your chat, but it's coming like every 30 seconds in a big burst of chat.
There, but not there.
Yeah, it refreshed there. Huh. I don't know. But we can still see your comments, so that's good. So keep talking. But the first bit of fan art is from... Greg Hartung, as always.
That's the only bit we have.
It's the first and only.
The first and only bit of fine art we have tonight, so.
It's from Greg Hartung. And I'm going to zoom in on this so you can read it. The title is Never Underestimate a Mother's Devotion. This is obviously targeted for Jody. And Jody, her character, is over here saying, he was attempting to steal my babby. I had to shoot. And over here we've got Beanstalk saying, it's all right, ma'am. You did the right thing by acting defensively.
I don't know if that's necessarily me.
Is that not Beanstalk?
It's not quite a fedora.
No, it's not quite a fedora, but it's some sort of goblin bruiser, because there's one right there with a fedora on.
Yeah.
And a dead elf, right? And I have to say, any piece of fan art that includes a dead elf is good fan art, in my opinion. So thank you very much for that, Greg Hart. It's because I switched. Watch, it'll pop back on in just a moment. See? There you go. So thank you very much, Greg Harton, for that awesome piece of fan art.
Patrick's Beanstalk is a dwarf. I've moved on.
Whoa!
Hey, look, 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 look. I'm still a goblin at heart, guys. And if I was able to come back to be a goblin again, I would in a heartbeat. But I can't, so I'm sorry.
You can't. No.
I'm still in a raid every Friday night, and we're 7 of 8 right now. Yes. I mean, I've downed Deathwing and then looking for raid, but in our regular 10-man, which is harder, we've done 7 of 8. And we're on Deathwing. We'll probably get him down on Friday. So
really?
Tomorrow. Yeah.
Tomorrow?
Yeah.
All right, we're going to have to let us know how it goes. If you get any super fat loot, tell us all about it.
I just might.
Are there any cool mounts that drop off of Deathwing?
I don't know about Deathwing. I think there's one that drops off of Ultraxium.
Ultraxium?
Yeah, the fifth boss of that raid.
Now tell me, like, I got sure exactly who Ultraxium is.
It's a dragon that guards the way to kill Deathwing.
Oh, so he's like a guard.
Right, on top of the spire in Dragonblight. You know that big, huge tower in Dragonblight? Well, at the top of that is where the fight takes place.
I see. Interesting. Yeah.
And everybody... And he brings you into an alternative dimension.
Yeah.
And he'll do his big, huge move, and if you don't click the button to go to the other dimension, you all die.
All right, well, you know what? I'm probably speaking out of turn here, but I know my audience. And I would venture a guess that if you recorded your adventures, if you recorded yourself and your guild downing these bosses or whatever, and put them up on YouTube, you would have a ready audience just waiting to watch your videos and follow you on Facebook, and you too could become a social internet icon. Like,
I don't want to be. I don't care about that kind of stuff.
You mean you don't care about the fans?
I'm not saying that.
I'm
just saying I don't even have the program needed to record that kind of stuff. I don't got fraps.
You can get fraps. It's really cheap. Yeah. In fact, I have fraps. You could borrow it on my computer.
All right. But it's really bugging me. I can't see the chat.
Well, you can read the comments. So the nice thing about that you could go through the comments, and you'll have a chance to read them before they fly off the screen now.
Yeah, some of them. I don't get all of them. All of a sudden, bam, who knows what we missed.
That's true. I guess we'd have to scroll up.
I mean, good luck when smoke ship time comes.
See, this one, it's working. See, there, it just went through it again.
It works on that screen? No.
It just flew through them again. However, if you touch this one, it's not working. Okay, that's interesting. So if I Alt-Tab and I'm no longer touching that screen, it doesn't update. But whenever I go over to it and then click it, it updates.
Well, you're going to have to keep up on there.
Yeah, I am. Nat says the chubby cigar is lagging the chat. All right, maybe the chubby cigar is lagging the chat. But thankfully, I am a voracious talker. So I have a lot more to say. And as long as I have a lot to say, you guys aren't going to get bored, are you? Don't worry, we're going to get your questions. Keep your questions in mind. We will do our best to answer them. And you know what doesn't have lag? Twitter. That's right. If you want to ask your questions on Twitter or on Facebook when the time comes.
Why is it lagging? Why is it not doing it?
Like I just told you. So we've got this one is over here. And if I were to do this over here.
Well, keep it over there.
Well, just read this one.
Is it updating correctly?
No. Maybe my theory isn't the best, but anyway. Don't worry about the comments. It's going to cycle through eventually. See, look, these guys... There, see, it just went through. I don't have Twitter, says Ghoul Breath. I got Facebook, though. It's the lack of scotch, says Volane. You know, maybe it is the lack of scotch. This is... the moment I stop having scotch in the show, this is what happens. Anyway, we have other segments of the show to get through. First, of course, is... This Day in History.
This Day in History.
All right. This Day in History for all music fans... In 1968, American singer Johnny Cash recorded his landmark album at Folsom Prison. Live at the Folsom State Prison in Folsom, California.
Is that right?
A true landmark in music. In fact, I could probably sit here and sing every song from his album right off the top of my head without even thinking about it because I'm that much of a Johnny Cash fan. Don't anybody try and put me to the test, though, because I wouldn't be able to do it. So that's this week in history. And, of course, we also have don'ts for husbands and don'ts for wives.
I can't do a show like this.
Calm down.
Okay, fine.
They're there, and they're still reading, and they're still watching.
All right.
It's taking. There you go. See?
Don'ts for husbands.
Okay.
Don't nag your wife. If she has burnt the cake or forgotten to sew on a button, she doesn't want to be told of it over and over again.
But what if she doesn't change? What if she continues to sew on buttons incorrectly and burn cakes?
Then nag away.
Okay.
All right, so don't shout when you are angry. It isn't necessary to let your children or the servants know all about it. Servants.
Because as we all know, I have servants.
Don't scowl or look severe. Cultivate a pleasant expression if nature hasn't blessed you with one.
This is good advice. I'm digging it.
Don't
scowl.
Don't let off steam on your wife or children every time anything goes wrong in the garage or the garden or the fowl house or in the dark room.
Because that would burn them.
Fowl house.
Steam is hot.
Try to realize that they have nothing to do with it, and that it is unfair to make them suffer for it.
That's very true.
All right.
The fowl house.
Don't allow yourself to become selfish. It is so easy because wives are mostly ready to give way.
Oh.
Watch yourself, and if you find that you always tend to appropriate the most comfortable chair or the warmest corner or the most interesting book, just check the habit. Don't quarrel with your wife. She can't if you won't. Mud sticks, and so do words spoken in anger.
That's right. Words spoken in anger are bad.
All right, and the last one we'll do. Don't refuse your wife's overtures when next you meet if you have unfortunately had a bit of breeze. Remember, it costs her something to make them. And if you weren't a bit of a pig, you would save her the embarrassment by making them yourself.
Wow. This is really hard on husbands, isn't it?
Overtures?
Overtures, yeah. Have you heard that expression?
Yeah, I think so.
Give an overture to somebody.
Okay. Anyways, yeah.
All right, I figured it out, by the way.
What?
So, as you can see, nothing is flying on the screen.
Yeah.
Watch this.
All right, so here.
No, you got to continue to do this.
I will.
You got it. You're going to sit there and you're going to twirl it around the entire time?
Yeah.
All right, there we go. It's going to happen. Just give it a sec. That is the cure. As soon as someone says another thing. There, see? There. That's it. All right, my turn to read Don'ts for Wives. Don't tread on your husband's metaphorical pet corns. There are plenty of other people who will do that. You needn't help. Pet corns? Must be some 1913 expression that I don't know about. Don't think you can each go your own way and be as happy as if you pulled in double harness. In all important matters, you want to pull in together. Don't expect all the give to be on his side and all the take on yours. True wives, don't take. You better give to your husbands, too. Don't argue with a stubborn husband. Drop the matter before argument leads to temper. You can generally gain your point in some other way. That's right. Don't manage your husband too visibly. Of course, he may require the most careful management, but you don't want your friends to think of him as a henpecked husband.
Wow, those are some good ones.
You did a great number of them right there. Caught on film. Watch. There you go. Nicely done.
Ha!
Recorded for posterity. Above all, never let him think that you manage him. The last one before we move on, ladies and gentlemen. Don't wash your dirty linen in public, or even before your most intimate friends. If there are certain disagreeable matters to discuss, take care to discuss them in complete privacy. See, at first I thought they were talking about real linens, but now I realize it was metaphorical. Dirty laundry being gossip. What are you doing? What are you doing? You're going to close my tabs. Don't close my tabs.
I'm not closing it. I'm trying to find it.
What are you trying to find? What are you trying to find?
The one that popped up here. Where'd it go?
It's not a tab. It's a running program.
Well, you could have told me that.
I didn't know what you were trying to do.
All right.
There you go. That's the one right there. All right. Well, ladies and gents, that has been Don'ts for Husbands and Don'ts for Wives. I know you guys want us to do Songify, and we will, probably later on in the program. My brother is instead preoccupied with clicking the screen voraciously because he's just entertained.
And not.
You know what you could do?
I'm getting a text. Hold on.
You could go between the two. Like this one right here, and then that one right there, and then that one right there, and then that one right there. All right. Classy Word says JMixer08. That's right. I forgot Classy Word of the Week. Today's Classy Word is... what?
Brian Meek got banned from WoW.
What? How did he get banned from WoW?
Brian Death Knight in my raid. He got banned. Huh?
What did he do?
Oh, yeah, you guys can probably figure it out. I'm not going to say it on here. I don't want to incriminate him, so.
I'm really curious. I want to know what he did. Was he gold farming? Was he ninja looting? What did he do? Was he talking profanely? What?
One of those things.
What? It was one of those things.
No, it wasn't actually.
It wasn't any of those things. What did he... He got banned, like, permanently?
Like no, all no, it's always temporary.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, they give you a warning and they ban your account for like 48 hours or something. But that's going to suck, though, if he can't get back, because he's supposed to raid with us tomorrow night, so... I don't know.
There you go, your plans for getting down Deathwing. Crap.
I know, right? If we don't have all 10 of our regular raiders, we have no chance.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for the question and answer portion of the program. As always, I will be reading this chat, even if it is a little buggy. But I give preference to questions asked of me on Twitter. And, you know, sadly, since we are having to deal with a weird chat situation, I'm not going to post on Facebook because that's one more window I would have to have open. But instead, please send all questions about the show on Twitter to @Oxhorn. And that is a lot of wine. How much is left in that bottle? All right, we got a little left. That's cool. Anyway, I am at Oxhorn if you're on Twitter, and if not, feel free to continue to post here. Maybe I should get Facebook up. Nah, I don't want to deal with Facebook right now. So, what is on your mind, ladies and gentlemen? We have the answers to questions that I know that you have. Glafleet on Twitter says, Ron Paul 2012 or not? Definitely not, just because he has horrible foreign policy.
Ron Paul?
Yeah, Ron Paul. I love his economic plan. He's brilliant on the economy. And he's got some definitely passionate followers.
Yeah.
But his foreign policy is isolationist. And I sadly cannot get behind an isolationist foreign policy.
I know, me neither.
Yeah.
I can say a lot of stuff about Ron Paul.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Me too. We're both really knowledgeable about Ron Paul.
I'm not going to, though.
Not going to.
No way.
I will, however, say that he's the Lyndon LaRoche of our own time.
Yeah, Lyndon LaRoche.
And for those of you who don't know who that is, Google him.
I know who that guy is.
Lyndon LaRoche. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I read a book about him.
I bet you do.
All about him, too.
Yeah.
Anyways, you forgot to do the classic word. Did you have him prepared?
Oh, yeah. Serendipitous.
Serendipitous.
Today's classic word is serendipitous.
Okay.
The fact that our chat is not functioning properly is not serendipitous.
Yeah.
If it suddenly turned gold and spewed out candy, that would be serendipitous.
Very nice.
Do you like classical music? Asks Sentiris Sukaro on Twitter. Absolutely. I listen to classical music every day on the way to work and on the way back. I also have a Pandora playlist that's got Beethoven and Mozart and some of the greats at work. So yes, I'm a fan of classical music. Hey Bean, are you going to be on later? Asks Louis199.
What, on World of Warcraft?
I'm assuming so.
Do
you know who that is?
Who?
Louis199.
I do not. Sorry.
Sorry, Louis, we don't know who you are.
I probably not. I'm tapped out valid points on my Death Knight, so the only reason to play is on my Shaman, and he's going to be doing all his stuff tomorrow night, so... Mm. Probably not.
I just lost my Ash. It's all over the carpet now. Nah, what a bummer. Joey Avalion on Twitter says, hey Oxhorn, me and my girlfriend are looking, my girlfriend and I, by the way, are looking to move Heal Priest and Tank Paladin to a new server. Whose server should we move to, yours or Bean's? What did you do?
That was good.
Okay. Well, if you want to join the Invisible Pink Unicorns, you've got to go to mine, Silverhand, US server. If, however, you want to do some elite raiding and have a guaranteed spot with Brian and his raid. A guaranteed spot. Well, you're just going to have to transfer
to
the server.
What are you saying, man?
He will guarantee you a spot in his raid, I'm sure.
You know, I'll tell you what. If we had 15 good raiders switch over to our server and join our guild, I guarantee you a spot in our 25-man raid.
Yeah.
But you would need to find 13 other people.
And you'd have to prove yourselves. There's an application form.
Yeah,
you've got to go through 2 interviews and find a red door and walk up a staircase and through 2 gates. That's what you got to do.
Yeah, that's right.
Ironbark says the IPU is awesome. That's right, the Invisible Pink Unicorns is an awesome guild, isn't it? Mike Chessel on Twitter says, Dear Oxhorn, hey Ox, good day to you. My fan art didn't send. Would you mind showing it anyway? Here's the link. Thank you, good sir. Hashtags class and Ox. Absolutely, my friend.
Well, he said good sir, so I'm sure he will.
This is a great one. All right, I'll just show it to you. All right. Here is his fan art, and it's hard to see, but it's an animated GIF. So he's making fun of the Dos Equis commercials. And the text says, I don't always drink scotch, but when I do, I drink Dos Equis. I drink Glenfiddich. That's pretty great. I'm even holding it right there, even, aren't I?
Yeah.
Stay classy, my friends. That's pretty great. By the way, that was a screen grab from a movie I did a long time ago. What was it? Oh, that was from the end of Inventing Swear Words 2.
There we go.
That's right. It's right there. You got to click on that red. There you go. And you got to choose the top one. Top one. There you go. That was great, Mike. Nice job.
Some other people want you to check your email again for more fan art.
Oh, did you guys send more fan art?
Somebody might have. I don't know.
Yeah, okay. You know, you guys really got to do this before the show starts so that I, Oh, it's my cute little hardcore kitten again. All right, cute little hardcore kitten. Let's see what you got here. And it's sideways.
Thanks for the sideways pick.
How am I going to be showing off a sideways pick? All right, hold on. Cute little hardcore kitten giving me work to do on my own program. Complain. All right, hold on a second. There we go. All right, I'm going to show it to you guys. Here we go. So this is fan art from I'm a Cute Little Hardcore Kitten, and what we have here is a guy sitting down in World of Warcraft. Apparently, he took a picture of his monitor with his phone. Now, I know hitting print screen on the keyboard is hard, but what's got to be more difficult is using your camera to take a picture of your screen. But anyway, and the text says, I am a cute little hardcore kitten featuring I am a cute little hardcore panther. Copyright. Okay, this leads me to a pet peeve of mine. And, you know, I hate to get like this, but how is that Oxhorn fan art? What on earth does that have to do with Oxhorn? You're basically just doing self-promotion. You're promoting yourself. I'm a cute little hardcore kitten. All right. Well, he sent me another one. What's this other one? All right, you sent... And this one is also sideways. Okay, we're downloading it, and we're going to show off this one. Is this more self-promotion? I'm a cute little hardcore kitten. If I can find it. Alright, so this one is another guy in-game, standing there again, he took a picture with his camera, and the text says, how? That really hurt, Ox, why did you backslap me? Come on, I know you hate elves and all, but seriously, what the heck? And he's saying that because he's standing next to Ox of the Mithril Order in Kalimdor. This is good fan art, because it is pertinent to the topic of the program, which is, of course, me. So thank you for that, I'm a cute little hardcore kitten. Fan art is always welcome here.
He says I got bored.
Okay, that's understandable. Boredom is a rough thing to be. My cure for boredom is work.
You need to fix your stuff, dude.
This is a live stream issue. It's not a me issue.
Oh, wow. You need to get at him.
I should. I should send them an angry, terse letter.
Yeah.
A thick letter on cardboard.
All right.
I said that joke again this week because I don't think any of you got it last week. So just a stiff letter on... All right, Twitter. What's okay? Sam Nichols says, "Any booze 80 proof or above that will burn."
Yeah.
I do. This stuff will normally burn. In fact, it caught on fire for a brief amount of time. I bet you it's because I didn't fill the cup all the way.
I just think it's old.
It doesn't lose its flammable qualities because it gets old. Besides, the best booze is aged.
Okay.
Right? Like, how old was that booze you got me for my bachelor party?
31 years.
It was 31 years old. Exactly. And it was amazing. The best scotch I've ever had in my life. This guy bought me 30-year-old scotch. It was brilliant. But that stuff, I'm sure, would have burned very well. Do you like the Three Stooges? Asks... Whoa, what happened?
I don't know.
Do you like the Three Stooges? Asks somebody whose face flew off the screen and I lost it. Man, what if this works? Nope, it doesn't work. Oh, there we go. And yes, I do love the Three Stooges. They are hilarious. In fact...
Hey, it's working now.
Is it working now?
Yeah.
Awesome. In fact, I once sat down and watched a marathon of Three Stooges stuff on Netflix, and then sat there for a couple hours doing research on the biographies of all of the people involved in the Three Stooges. And
it's working now.
Fascinating. They had great lives.
Okay, Ghoulbreath is asking, Ox, do you like The Princess Bride?
Again, yes, I love The Princess Bride. I've got it on DVD. You know, yeah. Brian and I grew up on that movie.
Yeah, our parents used to show it to us when we were kids.
Indigo Montoya. He was my favorite.
Yeah, Indigo Montoya.
Mm-hmm. You killed my father. Prepare to die.
Yeah.
Then, of course, Andre the Giant, dream of large women. Great show.
Yeah. As you wish. As you wish.
You know what next word's, week's classy word is going to have to be?
What?
Inconceivable!
Oh, is that right?
I do not think it means what
you think it means. What you think it means.
We know the secrets of the fire swamp. We can live there happily for some time, so anytime you feel like dying.
Alright, so I messaged Brian Meek and asked him if he's going to be here for the raid tomorrow. Let's see what he says.
Alright, what'd he say?
Alright,
Rob Reiner is a weird guy, but that was a good movie. What's he say? I want to know what he was banned for. That's what I want to know.
I don't know. Actually, he says they turned it off because they think he got hacked.
Oh, so he didn't actually do anything wrong.
Well, because he was traveling and logged into the hotel internet and then switched to his phone, and I guess it bugged it.
That's stupid. They should know
better. So I think it should be fixed if that was the case. I mean,
he could just sell a ticket.
I thought it was for something else.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Is he partaking in some sort of...
of course not.
Black hat World of Warcraft behavior?
Of course not.
You're going to have to fill me in after the show.
No.
Yeah? He's got his secrets, whatever. Okay, LF... You know what? I gave you a shout-out last week. I'm not giving you another shout-out this week. I'm so glad you guys are here. You're totally welcome.
Who?
But it's a guy. They do something. They...
Who?
It's... Okay. Were you here last week?
Yeah.
I'm not telling you who!
Who is it?
They want another shout-out!
He's so stubborn!
I'm a stubborn guy, I gotta say. I don't know. Alright. What are your favorite raids and instances to run in WoW? Asks Leah Reynes. Ryan, I believe you are much more eminently qualified to answer that question.
No. They want to know your favorite.
My favorite raids and instances. I do not like Oculus. That annoys me. I'm also sick of Strathom. Blah. You know, I really enjoyed vanilla WoW instances. I had a lot of fun with Blackrock Depth and Lower Blackrock Spire.
Ah.
What'd you do? Quick close.
Okay, but so the only raids I've ever played is Bastion of Twilight, Throne of Foreign Winds, Blackwing Descent, Firelands, and Dragon Soul, the new one. Those are the only ones that I've raided a lot and have done them when they were current. And I don't know.
I don't believe I've ever done a current raid. Oh! Dire Maul. The day Dire Maul was released, I was there. And I went through that entire dungeon. That was fun.
Yeah.
Long time ago.
That is a long time ago.
That was fun. So I just realized that we have 20 minutes left in the program, and I'm not even 2 inches into my cigar yet. So you're going to see me start puffing really voraciously.
Come on. Willers asks Mr. Beanstalk how's the cigar. It's pretty fine. I actually enjoy this cigar.
Do you remember what it's called?
No.
Well, you'll have to remember for next time.
I told you. Why don't you remember?
Dude, I think you're smoking from the wrong end.
I am not.
Did you...
There was a band at the end.
Okay. Wait, at there?
Yes.
Yeah, you're smoking from the wrong end.
No, this is a band right here.
Yeah, the band is closer to your mouth.
Yeah.
The band is always closer to your mouth.
Maybe See? That's why it's so nice.
Because you're smoking it the wrong way.
Maybe that's why it's so nice. I'm going to start smoking my cigars the wrong way every night.
All right. Well, I'm glad you're developing a new love of cigars. Hey, Oxhorn says, barking at the moon. What do you think of Perry the Platypus? Is that like a new Teletubby?
Oh yeah, what do you guys think of Howard the Duck?
Okay, yeah, you gotta tell me about that show. So, here's the thing. Last time Brian was over, I caught him starting Howard the Duck on Netflix, and I didn't tell him about it, because I just wanted to gauge his natural reaction. So, how did you enjoy Howard the Duck?
Well, I fell asleep. I caught the last part.
How far?
Very, very 80s.
Very 80s?
Yeah. But I like that little duck. Howard's awesome.
Is he?
Oh, yeah. He's got an attitude. He saves the day. He gets all the women. Yeah. Howard's a bad...
A bad apple.
A bad apple.
All right.
Yeah. Anyways.
So, in film history, Howard the Duck is considered to be the worst film of all time.
Is that right?
It is considered to be the worst film of all time.
Howard's awesome, man. Well, no, I was in my vent the other night, and we had a couple of pugs in our vent that we don't usually run with, and I don't know, something came up about Howard the Duck, and so I just had to check it out for myself, because I'd never heard of it.
Well, now you know. Now you know Howard
the Duck. Now I know Howard the Duck.
The worst film of all time.
They should make a sequel.
Really?
Yeah.
Good luck with that happening. It's not doing anything, is it?
No, it's not.
Well, you got it up to... Oh, there you go. Oh, that's another one. Sen Sukar says, Oxhorn Bean, did you ever do the Scarlet Monastery and did you like it? Yeah, I do enjoy the Scarlet Monastery. And I'm glad that they included the Scarlet Monastery with the Halloween holiday quests, because it's always fun going back in there. And I'm really glad that they included Black Rock Mountain in the Brewfest quests, because that's another fun instance that I really enjoyed from Vanilla WoW.
Your wind is screwing me up here.
Wind. Yeah. It was hot in this room. I had to open a window.
All right.
We're doing some pretty epic smoke rings today. So here's another thing. At that smoke easy that I went to, I was the only one there doing smoke rings.
Really?
Really. I don't know if it's like some sort of faux pas thing where, oh, everybody knows that they do smoke rings, so they don't do it or something. But I sat there in that leather chair with scotch in my hand, and I just blew out a steady stream of smoke rings. And there were a number of people that just came up to me, and they're like, I was putting on a show. I really was. Okay, this is what you need to do. Here, stop. Put this over here, and then go bink, and then bink. See? That fits. Try again. Bink, and then bink, bink. Bink. Ah, why isn't it working?
Because it's screwed up.
There we go. See? Bink. Right, yeah. Bink. Or here. Okay. Here, better yet. We'll switch between Twitter and back.
Ah.
So we'll put this here so that you can see it nice and big.
Yeah.
And we'll go bink and then bink.
We're just binking all over the place.
Snoozer Gold says scream and panic. Y'all, man. Prata med mig dom snus är grott. Men jag tänker snus är inte grott. Jag tänker cigars and pipes är grott. Nej, snus.
Bink!
So all the Swedish people in chat are going to be able to see that I was talking Swinglish.
Swinglish.
Swedish English.
All right.
I do Swedish very bad.
All right, well, we better do Songify. It's about that time.
Is it time to do Songify?
I guess so. All right.
What should we talk about? How snus er grot?
I don't know. You do what you want, and I do what I want.
Okay. We shall do what we want. Even though we can't always get what we want, but just sometimes we get what we need.
It's very true.
It's going. Go for it.
Hey, guys. Where's the music?
The music is turned off because it would have interfered with our natural flow.
All right.
All right, indeed. And I like how you've almost finished my entire bottle of wine.
That's right, baby.
Did you just call me baby?
Oh, yeah, baby.
How you liking that wine, by the way? Is it tasty?
It's pretty good. I love it so much.
This gin is nasty, and the only reason I drank it is because I was hoping to set it on fire, and I couldn't.
I'm about to polish the bottle.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
All right, let's see how this one turned out. All right. So there you go. Another Song of Fly said and done, and I believe that one was a roaring success. Tune in next week for the next time we do Song of Fly.
That's right, baby.
You gotta stop calling me baby, bro. You gotta stop. And afterwards, my Pandora always freaks out. Unable to play. Fine, let's try something else. I got music on my machine here. Oh, yeah. Let's resume the Final Fantasy music.
Final Fantasy 9.
That's right. I have the entire album on here.
Vivi!
There's Vivi! Remember all these guys?
What
was that one called?
It started with a Q.
Q?
Maybe remember this guy's name. It started with a Q. The guy on the far right in the red. The guy with the huge tongue.
Chef's hat and the long tongue.
Qualoblet?
I don't know. Final Fantasy, they got some weird characters.
Yeah. I remember Vivi.
Oxhorn, what are some tips for a sophomore in high school to help him stay classy? Says Nate Burr. Well, don't get me started, but I have classy tips for you. First, when you take a woman out, pay for her meal. Don't force her to pay.
Queena,
that's right. It was Queena, wasn't it?
I knew it was her with a Q.
Second, make sure that you have a shirt that's tucked in. And if you cannot wear a belt, suspenders are absolutely fine. Make sure also that the hems of your pants are not ratty and that you are cleanly shaved if you go that way, or that your beard is nicely trimmed. After you take her to the drive-in and the people come up with roller skates and serve you your food, only put your arm around her if you can feel that she's down
for
that.
Look at these smoke rings. Look, they were awesome, and then your wind screwed them up. Bam.
I was talking.
Bam.
Oh, I destroyed it.
See? You see? It's like...
That was archery. Archery with my mouth.
Yeah. Why did you do it?
That was great. I know, but those are tips on how to stay classy as a sophomore. Also, don't do wrestling. Trust me. Don't do wrestling. Just saying. No. Anyway, if you would like more classy tips for being a sophomore in high school, I have some. I'll put them on my blog. How long have you been doing Oxhorn? Asks Alexander Allen K. While playing music vids and this stream. Very good question. I have been doing Oxhorn since 2004. The end of 2004, the beginning of 2005, around that area. The very first time I quote-unquote did Oxhorn was with Hark Hear the Whales. I think that was my first movie. And I've been doing that ever since. This show is over 2 years old. I've been doing it for 129 weeks. So count it up. That's over 2 years. And I've had my website since 2009. My current website. I had an older website, which the very talented John DeJordi was a moderator for way back in the day. Yeah, I've been doing it for a while. How many of you have kids that are 5, 6, 7 years old? Because it's 2012, and I've been doing this since 2005, so that's 7 years. Holy cow, I've been doing this for 7 years. Makes one ponder. This gin is just... Ugh.
You good?
Oh, take a sip of that. It's better with the water. Whoa! What about me? You didn't think about me when you drank my gin, did you?
Well, there's a big thing of it right over there.
Yes, there is. Oh, I like this song. Alright, I wonder if I can set this on fire. This really makes me want to play Final Fantasy again.
Yeah.
Ah! It's hot. Yeah, I can't get it to flame. My bad. I'll figure it out. Barking at the Moon says, someone send Ox some scotch. Please. Please, I'm out of scotch. I'll try and have some in time for next week. I will try. It's on my list.
You better check Twitter. There have been some posts.
Okay, well, we're on Twitter right now.
Oh, are we?
That's the column we can read. Do you want to read some off for me?
No.
Patrick says, testing to see if this works. Great. It works. And then she says, if it does, has Bean ever heard of A Little Bit? Doesn't look like it when it comes to pouring a drink. I think that one hit home. Weren't you like holding something back for Patrika that you you weren't gonna say on camera, but no?
I have to stay classy.
You have to stay classy, so you're not gonna say anything?
I have to remain classy.
All right, my friend. Oh, I better pour some water into there. Hey, Nova is in the chat. My beautiful wife. She says, stopping by just to say hello, finished cooking dinner. How is everyone? I am really looking forward to this dinner.
Pot roast, right?
I think it's pot roast, yeah. I'm pretty ravenous.
I'm hungry.
She always cooks amazing roasts.
Yeah.
Don't you think so?
Yeah.
Yeah, she does.
I love all of her cooking.
She does awesome
cooking. I love anything and everything when it comes to food.
All right, you know what she made for me a few nights ago?
What?
She made me a bowl of meatballs and little smokies soaked in a chili and grape jelly sauce.
Yeah?
It was really good. Apparently it's like a southern dish, and she made it for like Thanksgiving or Christmas, and it was amazing.
Oh yeah, well, my girl cooked me tilapia.
Fish?
Yeah.
I'm not a big fan of fish.
No, it was fried in oil on a pan.
Yeah.
With crisp green beans.
Yeah, I'm sure there are people out there that can appreciate that, but I'm not a fish person.
You need to appreciate a good tilapia.
You know what? I have to say though, even though I hate fish, I would try piranha.
Why?
Because they want to eat you.
So you want to eat them back.
So I want to eat them back. That's my reasoning. Oh, my bad. The guy who's wanted another shout out, who I refused to do a shout out for, says, I was thanking you. I wasn't asking for it again. My bad. And just for that, LF morons. Those are the guys.
Looking for morons.
Looking for morons.
Oh, that is a Machinima group?
I believe it's a Machinima group, yeah. And I'm giving you another shout out, my friends, because you are classy individuals.
That was a ox faux pas.
An ox faux pas, exactly. Do you know how to spell faux pas?
Yeah. P-H-O-P-A-W.
That's right, my friend.
Faux like in the Vietnamese soup.
But that's pronounced pho.
Faux then faux pas.
F-A-U-X-P-A-S.
Really?
Yep. Faux pas. Yeah.
Who cares?
They're all like, faux pas?
What?
Faux pas.
Faux pas? No, P-H-O. P-H-O.
Oxhorn, what brand of scotch would you like to drink? Asks Aries World. I like Glenfiddich. I love Laphroaig. Gosh, Grant's is nice. Dewar's is also nice. Really, I'm not particular. Scotch is great. Oh, Glenveld. Glenveld is also nice.
It's that time, guys. Smoke ship ideas. Please give them to us right now, and we will try to decipher them through this terrible chat.
Smoke ship ideas are probably better sent to us on Twitter. It would be easier for us.
All right, send them to Twitter.
You on can, chat if you can't do Twitter, but...
You can put them in here if you want, but... Okay.
Whoa!
Oh, see, I told you, this guy screwed up.
The Cigar Club transforming into a giant smoke ring-powered rocket and... I'm sorry, here. A giant smoke ring-powered rocket and flying off into space to populate a planet where the rivers run scotch and sky has cigar smoke clouds.
Yeah.
And wild kodos run free. Veronicus, you are a very creative individual. I gotta say, he goes above and beyond when it comes to smoke ring ideas. He really does. Right, you read them off because I'm going to smoke this really fast.
Jay makes your oxen being in a bacon pontoon going on an old gin and like going through a long interview to join a secret smokers club. Bean impatiently searches the Kraken while Ox reminisces about Vanilla Wow. Oh,
OMG?
I don't know. Gulbra says Bean clicking a lot on the computer because he drank too much wine, calling Ox baby, and singing to Songify while he sails a ship of bacon.
That's oddly pertinent. Because he's calling me baby because of the wine.
Listen, baby, that's not pertinent.
Okay, thanks, bro.
I don't think it's pertinent at all. And I do not click too much.
This is why you don't smoke cigars too fast. They get a little bitter.
Woo. I do. A little hard. All right. Chase Yes is Oxen Bean sitting on a glass ship throwing bacon balls at tied-up elves. And after that, they go putt gnomes... Of the fence off of the boat.
Of the fence of the boat.
Of the fence of the boat, yeah.
Those are gnomes that are both from a fence and from a boat. Of the fence Of the boat.
Of the boat.
Kadarin says, my new son Nicholas, shooting laser beams of Care Bear death, stare at Oxhorn while Hat sings him a lullaby. Congratulations on your new son Nicholas, by the way.
Yeah. Yeah. That's, how about jazz? That's what you said.
Patrica says, a submarine with Bean, Wit Bean, she said Wit.
Wit Bean.
A submarine Wit Bean searching the ocean's floor for hidden treasure of Kraken, an ox tryin to stop the war of clicking noise. Oof, I should not have smoked that so fast. Oh, gotta drink something.
Head rush. Yeah. Wow. Ah, crap. Oh, man.
This is why you watch scotchandsmokerings.com, because I show you the things you should not do. Don't smoke too fast. Whew. Sora Mifune says, Oxhorn flying a dragon over a field of terrified dwarves and elves.
Beautiful!
Of all the races of alliance, I gotta say, dwarves are probably not so hated, in my opinion. If I had to be alliance, I would probably be a dwarf.
That's what I am.
Bacon-covered gnomes and Bean making clicking madly drunken from bacon soda. Bacon soda? And Ox having fun dancing with Nova. You just gave me an awesome idea for a new cooking ingredient. Instead of baking soda, bacon soda. Add a nice bacon flavor to the cake you're going to make. Bacon soda.
All right, well, let's do the smoke chip. Pick one.
All right. Ox and Bean in a bacon pontoon going an old gin lake. Going through a long interview to join a secret smokers club. Bean impatiently searching for Kraken while Ox reminisces about Vanilla Wow. All right, Jay Mixer, you have won. We're going to do that one. A bacon pontoon. That sounds good. Well, I'm really lightheaded. I'm not doing that again. All right, ladies and gents, it is time for a smoke chip. Are you ready?
Screw your win.
This is how it's done, my friend.
Yeah. I'm ready. You're at a different angle. The wind is like...
Yeah? Watch.
Mm-hmm. See how it takes them away? It takes them away. It just takes them away.
I'm feeling a little bit of a breeze, but come on. A bad carpenter blames his tools.
Let's go here.
All right. Smoke ship time. Are you ready? Did you see it? Hoo-wee! For the briefest of moments, it was there, on a beautiful Scotch lake. Bean and I, in a bacon pontoon, trying to get to the secret smokers club, while Bean impatiently searches for Kraken in the shallow waters. And I reminisce about Vanilla Wow while hiccuping, apparently.
Yeah.
And it was there, for the briefest of moments, painted in smoke. Just for you, fine ladies and gentlemen. Gentlemen.
Gentlemen. All right.
So then, before you guys leave, please check out the shop. I've got a lot of great items there. We're going to have new items every week. So this time next week, there are going to be a lot of cool, great items for you to get. Oxify yourselves. Start to develop an Oxhorn getup. And then if you do, take pictures of yourself with the items that you have purchased in your Oxhorn getup. And I will be sure to show them off here at scotchandsmokings.com. Buy my music. Keep going to my show. Join me on Facebook and on Twitter. Thank you all for coming to this week's episode of Scotch and Smoke Rings. Hey, do you have anything to say?
Yeah, I can ban people. I just figured that out.
Don't
I can
ban
click
them.
On people's names, and I can ban them for like 5 minutes, 24 hours, 2 weeks, or forever.
Now that you have the power, do not abuse it. With great power comes Spider-Man.
Responsibility.
Responsibility, okay.
I will not ban you guys.
All right, you will use that with great restraint.
Except for you, Ironbark. I'm banning you for...
2 hours.
2 hours?
You're going to ban him for two... Don't ban Ironbark!
Where is he?
He did nothing to deserve it. He's
Where
a good guy. Don't ban... No, no. Get your hand off the mouth.
There he is.
Get your hand off the mouth.
Give me your eye!
All right. And as always, ladies and gentlemen, I say, be sure, my friends, as always, to stay classy. No. Stop it. Oh, God.